presentation start now. Sir, I come now to a very important matter which is agitating the minds of the people of this country. It has become a subject of debate throughout the country. It is center-state relations. The center-state relations have got many aspects: the legislative, the executive, the political, and so on and so forth. I am not going to deal with them because that debate will continue in the House the day after tomorrow. I want to refer only to the financial aspect. Honestly speaking, the motive behind this question raised by some people is basically economic and financial. The demand that the states should have more autonomy and that the center's relations in the state should be revised has come out of financial and economic motivation. The demand for autonomy is there, but if you accept the autonomy as some people have demanded, what will happen? The existing regional imbalances will become wider, and only the advanced states will benefit and not the backward states. Therefore, we must be on our guard. We cannot support the demand for autonomy made by some advanced states. In that case, the advanced states will go forward and the backward states will become still more backward. Therefore, the question has to be examined from two angles: from the point of view of providing more avenues and opportunities to the states for resource mobilization, and at the same time, we must examine from the point of view of moving towards reduction of regional disparities. On the one hand, we should certainly create more opportunities for the states to mobilize resources, and on the other, we must see that there is a gradual reduction in the regional disparities. These are two objectives that have to be kept in mind when we discuss the question of regional autonomy. On the question of center-state relations in the existing pattern, sir, the center is the dominant partner in financial distribution. I agree the center cannot be strong, but I also say that the states also must be strong. The center cannot be strong at the cost of the states, nor the states at the cost of the center. Both must be strong. What is to be done? Because ultimately, whatever you plan, whatever you draft, whatever proposals you make, the ultimate implementation falls on the states at the grassroots level for all purposes. Sir, the 7th schedule should be revised in order to provide more avenues and opportunities to the states for resource mobilization. Article 268 and Article 269 of the Constitution refer to taxes and duties which accrue to the states, but why two different articles and why not one article based on the principle of equitable distribution among the states with the objective of reducing regional disparities? Sir, Article 270 refer to income tax only, but no to corporate tax. But in my view, corporate tax is also income tax, and therefore, why should not corporate tax be brought under the divisible pool as income tax has been brought? Article 271 talks about surcharges excluded from the divisible pool. Why should they be excluded from the divisible pool? I don't understand this. They must also be brought under the divisible pool. Sir, Article 272 talks of excise duty to be shared between the center and the states. The sharing is permissible and not compulsory. Why is it a permissible sharing and why is not a compulsory sharing like the income tax? Sir, Article 275 refers to grants in aid to the states out of the consolidated fund of the union. Article 280 talks of a finance commission to decide about sharing of the two taxes and the principles of grants in aid. Article 282 referred to grants from the union to the states for any public purpose, and Article 292 referred to loans from the center to the states. Now, sir, the actual position is very revealing. Sir, I am trying to summarize and I am not giving the details. There are statutory transfer of resources from the union to the states, and there are non-statutory transfers of resources from the union to the states. What is the ratio? Roughly speaking, the ratio is 32 and 68. Statutory transfer of resources is 32% and the non-statutory transfer is 68%. The statutory transfer is all right, but so far as a non-statutory transfer of resources is concerned, it depends entirely upon the bureaucrats at the center. And why should they depend on the whims and fancy of the bureaucrats at the center? This is the vital point, and this covers revenue receipts and capital receipts altogether. Approximately the 2/3 of the total funds to be shared by the states are transferred on the victims' whims of the officials.